the third week of the lockdown here in the UK, and we thought we help starting photographers to use the time to learn more about lighting, improve their skill, and we are planning to do a series of videos in the time in our home studio. And we start with the most important thing, that's lighting, and starting to see light and start to understand light is the most important thing a photographer can do. You need to invest, like in everything, you need to have a pencil and you need a piece of paper. And what you are doing with the piece of paper and the pencil, we explain next. The light is for human eyes invisible unless it falls off a subject, then it casts a shadow and we can see it. Here we have a hard light. Imagine it would be a sunny day, soft facing window, and the sun is shining direct into your window. You have a very distinct shadow from the pencil and no transition between the white of the paper and the black or gray of the shadow of the pencil. If you now move the pencil and the paper, you shouldn't see that the shadow change. We are moving our light source and have the same result. But if you go around from your window and move the pen and paper, you should see how the shadow changes with the angle of the light falling onto the pencil. Now we change to a softer light source. Think about a window in shadow, maybe a north-facing window in the afternoon where no direct sunlight, but light is coming in through the window. And as you see, the shadow is more feathered. It's not as dark, it's lighter, and you have a transition between the shadow and the piece of paper. And again, if you move it around, you see how it changed and how the light changed. And if it gets further away, that the light source gets smaller compared to the pencil and get harder. So, and that's what we mean with going around, trying to understand light and to see how it changed when the subject changed according to the light source. Now we are just using the frosted glass of our studio door, and as you see, it is much darker, so we opened up for the video, but the shadow is softer, it's feathered out, you have more transition from the shadow, and if you move the object, you can see how the shadow is moving. So go around with your piece of paper and pencil through your house, look at the lighting, look what the shadow is on the piece of paper from your pencil. I hope you found that helpful, gives you something to do, and hopefully you join us soon for the next video. Bye for now. Bye.